how can we help foster the public-private partnerships, bringing American capital and expertise and standards to Africa so that we can keep exploiting, so that we can exploring where we can get these minerals.
Wherever you are watching from, thank you so much, and I love you. You know that. Now, in today's video, I'm going to react on this video of Senator Todd. You know, the spirit of our forefathers, the spirit of our African ancestors did something for us, exposed the white people, exposed the America on their on what they are planning or on what they are doing against Africa. And we have been talking about these things that, oh, the oppressors are exploiting Africa. The America or British is exploiting the minerals from Africa. We have been talking about France. We have been talking about Germany. We have been talking about even Russia is looking upon Africa, you know. And there's this video. Watch this one.
Well, we have a role to play there, as do, of course, all our diplomats. So we'll continue to focus on this important area. With respect to technology, most especially our movement towards green energy, we need critical minerals. I'm glad it's something you brought up in your opening comments. If we can't get them through our deep seabeds by ratifying the laws, the Sea Treaty, which looks to be a challenge based on current circumstances, then we should look to Africa, which is where the preponderance of these minerals are. How can we help foster the public-private partnerships, bringing American capital and expertise and standards to Africa so that we can keep exploiting, so that we can exploring where we can get these minerals?
So if you look at like a balance sheet of the top 40 trace elements and minerals that are necessary for batteries or for semiconductors, the vast lion's share of those supplies are now controlled.
Now, welcome. This video of Senator Todd, I think he was in a certain panel. They were talking about development of United States of America. And something slipped from his mouth. And that's why they are looking ways, or they are exploiting Africa. He said that. He said that they are exploiting Africa. And he realized that it's wrong, that he doesn't, he was not saying like that now. he clears his throat and say that exploring Africa. How on earth can you transition from exploiting to exploring? It's very awkward. This is something that is in their mind about exploiting. It is something that they are doing on a daily basis. It is something that they sleep doing, and they waking up exploiting Africa. They think of exploiting Africa every now and then. It is their thing. It is the thing of the oppressors, the thing of the white people. And it's something that Senator Todd knows they are exploiting Africa, and it came out without him realizing that, whoa, shit, what have I done? You know, like, that's why I'm saying the ancestors, our ancestors, our forefathers, you know, expose their secrets. Now, when you talk about exploiting Africa, some people, I heard some Africans saying that they are coming here, we don't know what we can do with our resources, we don't know what we can do with our gold, we don't have equipments to mine our gold, we don't, you know, we don't have the machineries, we don't have the industrialization. But that's how Africa we want to be. We want to lack knowledge. It's not that we don't have knowledge. We have the knowledge. We can at least, we can do better with our resources. But we have given chances to the white people. We have given them chance to come here in Africa. And they are controlling the price. So when we decide to use our own resources, the price is very low. But when they come and they tell us, you know, the price is low, so we are taking with this price, and they are taking it to their countries, and then they bring back to us with the higher prices. You know, white people are in Congo. The oppressors are in Congo. They are exploiting Congo. They are causing wars to Congo. They are killing people there and taking their lands. If your land has mineral deep in your land, they come and take it away from you. And this is to show you that it's very evident that the oppressors, they are exploiting our resources, and they know they are benefiting from them. Because if it's not us, African people, trust me, America will not be great. If it's not for African people, trust me, the UK will not be great. If not for African people, the France will not be great. So Africa is the backbone of these nations. They know that. And that's why they have designed their system in a way that we as Africans, we will not benefit from our own resources. They are designing these things in a way that whenever they see a president of a certain country waking up, they plan a coup, they assassinate, they terminate, they create puppets, they create their own president of Africa. You may think that Africa, that in certain country, you may think that we have chosen a president of our own, the one who we love, but no. The president is being chosen by the system so that they can play their cards so well, so that they can continue exploiting and continue reaping where they did not sow. And we know, and they know, the only thing that will make them not to get all these resources is when all of African countries and African people will unite and speak one language, will unite and have that strength, all black people to unite and have all that strength. They know when we do that, they are done. And they planned this for so long. When they came and colonized, they planned this for so long. They came with the system, they came with religion, they came with borders, you know. They imagine they drew the borders with a pen and say Uganda will be here, Congo here, Rwanda, Burundi, and you can imagine how they managed to divide Africa. Only somewhere in Lancaster House, sitting down with a biro and a pen, creating borders so that they can divide Africa. That's what they did. And it we call it a long con. It was a long con. Brainwash, mind setting. They knew what they were doing, and they planned this for a long time. So we are living with this. Someone from Africa, someone from Kenya, and someone from Uganda, they will be fighting for Migingo Island. And you there thinking, this is Migingo Island, it is in Lake Victoria. What if all of us are here and we fish in this island? But we are fighting only for that. Someone from Kenya going to Uganda or going to Tanzania, when he crosses the border, it becomes a problem. And we are all black people. We are all Africans. We are all Bantu, for the crying. We are all Bantus. And that makes me to think that it was a long con, something that was designed, and it was put like it's a system. So the mind of Africans is being designed in a way that when I'm a Kenyan and I see a Rwandan, I see like this one is very different from me. When I am a Rwandese, I see a Burundian, I see like he is different from me. And both of us, we speak maybe one language. Maybe we are in French. We can understand bonjour. We can understand, you know, we can understand these languages. But it is designed in a way that if I see a Ugandan, I see like is someone different, you know. If I see a Ugandan in my country, maybe in Nairobi, I start asking questions. What are you coming here to do? You know, if I see a Somali coming here in Kenya doing business, I start asking questions. You are coming here and you are doing business here. You are succeeding. and we are all black people. So this was a long con for them to keep exploiting us, for us, the black people, for us Africans, to keep on fighting. That's why there's no peace in Congo. There's no peace in most of the countries. Look for a country like Burkina Faso, coup after coup. Now, the latest president, Ibrahim Traore, he is doing great, but they are still planning a lot of coups against Ibrahim Traore. Why? The people of Burkina Faso are happy with him. The people of Africa are happy with Ibrahim Traore because he is doing great. But why are they attempting coup? Right now, a number of coup is 13. 13 coups against Ibrahim Traore. Why do they want him out of power? Because they know his mind is very open. He knows what he's doing. He knows we can do without them. He chased the France out of Burkina Faso. Now the France are angry. They want to come back and exploit more from Burkina Faso. That's why they are creating rebels and, you know, they are creating people against Burkina Faso President Traore. They are bringing snipers. And let me tell you, a country like Gambia, Ivory Coast, they have a French military base is in Ivory Coast. And they're planning their agenda from Ivory Coast. Instead of Ivory Coast siding with Burkina Faso, Burkinabe, instead of Ivory Coast supporting Burkina Faso so that we can stand together as West African countries, we can come together and create this strong bond. Now, Ivory Coast is giving refugee to France military so that they can plan their agenda towards Burkinabe. Now, there is you may find this the war or the fight that is in Congo. Believe me, you may find a puppet, a president puppet in one of these African countries. He is the one giving information and causing all this chaos in Congo. Believe me or not, you will not see a white person coming here and fighting against each other. See what happened to Kenya, just the Gen Z protest. The protest was fueled by IMF. IMF knew that when we impose this tax to the people of Kenya, they will become furious and they will protest, and that's what they want. Now they want a country to have problem, and then they will pretend like they are coming to help you, and they are coming to give you the loans so that you can grow your country. Little do you know that these loans are killing your country, so that they will come and tell you, let us mine your gold, let us take your oil, and we will pay this debt that you have. That's how they keep exploiting Africa. That's how they keep digging our minerals. And you may find that maybe France, a country like France is very rich. A country like Britain, they have a bank only for gold. Gold bars, you know? And you came to think of it, where do they get this gold? They get it from Africa. And you come and see where Africans are mining those gold. They're all poor. As someone, 18 years old boy from Africa, 13 years old from Africa, has started mining gold, walking barefoot without shoes, eating once a day. And he is mining gold. At the end of the day, he gets a gold. And that's a lot of money. But because the white people does not want you to be rich with that gold, they will exploit you. They come and impose your with the cheap prices. So you are selling this gold in cheap prices, the money that even you can't eat for 2 days, and they going with that gold worth thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars, and you have only sell it for few coins. And that's how they're exploiting us. And we are here. you are digging or you destroy your land. We destroy our lands. We cannot do farming. We cannot do anything for our land because they have come here and take away our land, and they are here mining from our land. So we cannot do agriculture. We can't get food. We can't do agriculture, okay? But we can mine. But the minerals, we can't do anything with it. So it's a lose-lose in all way. You lose on mining, you lose on agriculture. And that's how they keep on exploiting Africa. Now, Senator Todd, he told us, okay, he told us it slipped from his mouth, but that was our ancestors at work. And each and every day, these secrets keeps on emerging. You saw the video I did about a white professor revealing the secrets of how they are doing to Africa. You know? So, I know you know where we stand. I know you know how Africans, we need to unite. From Egypt to South Africa, from Nigeria to Somalia, north, south, east, west, we need to come together. We need to speak. We need to support Ibrahim Traore because he is the only president that he is doing the right thing right now. He has called out the Africans from diaspora and Caribbeans to help us as Africans to unite, to be ambassador of unity. But you will see my president, William Ruto, he is the opposite of Ibrahim Traore. When Ibrahim Traore goes in the ground and giving to the farmers, giving them machineries, William Ruto is giving fake promises that he never did anything on it. You know where you lie. As an African, you know what you want. If you want to get visa, if you want to get green card and run away from Africa to go in a white man's land because you think it's greener, believe me, Africa is very green. It's just you don't know, but Africa is very green. You think greener pasture is in USA. But USA are getting their resources from Africa. So we have that food for thought. We have to think about ourselves. That's why we are talking to the youths. All the people are gone. All the people, all they think is about colonialism. They are thinking, you take someone like Yoweri Museveni, you think Yoweri Museveni will help you. Yoweri Museveni will not help because his mind is colonized and thinking about, you know, how to grow an empire, a family country, a country for a family. But youths, let me tell you one secret as I finish. When the colonial came to Africa, and King Leopold II was the king of Belgium, he gave instructions to the missionaries who we think they brought religion. He gave instructions to them and told them, go and teach the young people because the old people, they know the right thing. Now they came and taught the young people about the, you know, do this and this, this and this. And the entire generation was being colonized. And they told us that the gold of this earth is not ours. Our gold as Africa is in heaven. How do you understand that? They told you the gold of the world is not ours. Our gold is in heaven. Now we as African people, we are giving away our gold, we are giving away our copper, we're giving away our resources, all of them, thinking that when we die, we will get our gold in heaven. Okay. Let's leave there. Now, they taught the youths, and it was a whole revolution. And that's now, right now, we want the youths, this message is for you, because you are the future. Tell me in the comment section what you think about this video, because sometimes I want to go to continue talking about this, but from the revelation we are getting from the white people, it's evident that they are doing what they know. Tell me what you think of the comment section. I am the Kenyan Beast, of course. We are doing it the African way every day, every time. Until next episode, peace be with you.